You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
Please, give my regard to the rest of the companions.
So rescued him from somewhere. And I'm wearing the vanilla mashup armors. I've got the Explorer outfit on. It's craftable at any blacksmith, anvil, crafting, what are they called, those things? A forge. I guess they're called forges. The only problem with the mashup armors is that it's only for dudes. If you throw it on a woman, she ends up with guy muscles. It comes with guy arms and guy legs. So you look kind of funny, you know, you got this woman head, but with guy arms and guy legs.
Assorted wares and tools.
For some, that might be the bee's knees, I don't know. So this is after I killed the daughter who lives here, the Shattershield kid. So I thought I'd come by, see how everyone's doing now that the children are all dead.
I just want to find a good husband.
Depending on what mods you have installed, this could be unsettling, or it could just be the norm. Okay, so the mom committed suicide. That's pretty rare, don't you think? In a Bethesda game, for a Skyrim game, I think that's pretty rare for someone to commit suicide. I want to say it happens a lot in Morrowind. And it might happen a little bit in Oblivion. I can't remember much about Oblivion. Well, I take that back. There's a lot of suicides in Skyrim. A whole lot. But it's people you never met. They're already... Like Fallout 3, they're people you don't meet. They're just... They always leave notes behind or a journal. Before they ended it all, they were surrounded by demons or mutants or whatever. So I take it back. Let's see, what else is going on in Windhelm? Slowly getting my skills going up. Just by waving my hand around, I increase my skills. I think in my next playthrough, I'm going to see if there's a... I'm going to try to use a mod that has birth signs in it. So you start out, your character starts out like you do in Morrowind. The way you create your character in Morrowind. I want to be able to use that kind of character generator in Skyrim.
My favorite drinking buddy. Let's get some mead. Got any ale or mead?
So he doesn't know about the daughter. He doesn't know about the mom. He doesn't know.
You've been a good friend in a time of need. And we won't forget that.
If you have Immersive Citizen AI Overhaul installed, he'll have something to say for sure.
I can teach you.
Let's see if he says it.
Forgive my mood. I'm still coming to terms with
Skyrim's staunch protectors, the Imperials. We drink to our youth.
Oh, I could barely hear what he was saying. And I can't read the subtitles below. I'll have to watch this on YouTube to see if he said wife and daughters. And restore what we own
with our blood and our steel. You always brighten my day a little. Depends. Are you thirsty? Hungry? Both.
She's not supposed to be alive, but there's mods. Mods kept her alive.
I hope we bump into each other again.
I don't know if it was worth doing that mod just to keep her alive, because everyone else still dies. So, on my next playthrough, I'll probably remove the mod.
How are you today?
And then just resurrect. I'll just resurrect the person if I need her. You know, not resurrect her, but just place a copy of her in the game. Because she still acts the same no matter if she's the original or if she's a copy of herself. It don't matter. She has no allies. She has no friends. What's going on here? Am I getting ready to pass out? I'm still addicted to Skooma at this point in the game. My character, no matter what I try to do, my character keeps helping himself to drugs. I have no control over it. Like, all of a sudden, he'll just reach in his pocket and take a swig of some juice. And as long as he keeps drinking stuff like that, he's fine, but if he stays off the juice for a while, he gets withdrawals, and then he's in panic mode. This herb tea is supposed to help with any side effects, any withdrawal symptoms. Yeah, your physical, your magical, and your mental.
How things been with you?
Is that how that works?
Good luck out there.
Like, if your brain is addicted to something, then you can't do certain magical spells, because certain ones use your brain. Ah! Ah! I always forget about that stupid gem. Shoot light. There's another one.
Strange.
I think there's like two of them that shoot lightning at me. Where are you going? You just totally walked right by me.
Did you hear that noise? Wonder what you're
doing. I'm not afraid.
I wish you wouldn't take so many risks.
So Rigmor sometimes and Vilya and me. I died before they had a chance to explode on me. Let's try again. I can barely move. How come? Oh, and then the soul gem kills me. Stupid soul gem. I was just goofing off here. Get the soul gem. Get the soul gem. Oh, that's cheating.
Did you hear that? Wonder what
come on.
Where's Rigmor?
You
kill the stuff.
Be so dead.
Kill the things. Oh, I see. These are the ones that they don't hop. They don't hop and explode. They just walk up to you and catch you on fire.
I don't want anything to happen to you.
Are we missing somebody? What are you doing up there? Come on, let's go. Oh no, not this thing. Almost. I'm almost dead. You guys shooting fireballs in the hallway here. Oh, now I'm dead. Nope, I just have broken. I think I have a broken back or something. It'll say up in the corner what happened to me just now. Let's see. I think Rigmor has the magic wand that keeps bringing back this irritating familiar that gets in the way of things. Oh, those eggs are still waiting for me to walk up to them. Let's try this. See, that's how it's supposed to happen. They're supposed to just dispatch the things quickly. Instead of standing around, we're all getting clobbered, no one's No one seems interested in actually killing anything. I'm just trying to film this for YouTube is all. You guys come in? Oh, this is a wall. Let me cut the wall so you guys can now pathfind your way in here. I'm tired of waiting for them. I'm just gonna go kill the things. What happens if I jump down there? Will they just open up? Oh! I felt that one. Oh, that's right. This place has all those geode things, which are kind of cool. Okay, that one doesn't open. And of course I can't walk. Gotta eat something to lose weight. Well, I'm doing pretty good in this playthrough. I haven't messed up my carry weight at all. A lot of times I'll mess up the carry weight, so it'll say I can't move, but I still have 10 more carry weight before I can't move. But in this playthrough I've kept myself fit as a fiddle. Everything I have on my person is accounted for, weight-wise. I don't have any invisible weights on me that I can't see, but they're there kind of thing.
I don't like where this is going.
I think we're supposed to kill that woman who,
How I'm gonna get you.
What was the deal with her? I'm trying to kill off Nella, I think, with Ashbaum. She wants revenge on Nella. Oh, I forgot about the rocks. My last playthrough, I cannot get this thing on the wall to trigger. So I was curious if it would work in this playthrough. Yay, it does work. I had some script of some kind from another mod that I'm not using. I can't remember what mod it was, and the scripts were just jamming all the time, so I just got rid of it. Oh, this person! Let's rescue this person. That's not creepy.
Thank you for rescuing me. That witch was gonna kill me soon. I just know it.
Need something?
Got some script jam, that's for sure.
All right, then.
She's supposed to have her hands tied or bound. She's got the sex lab aroused. Cranked up all the way on her for some reason. Aye, well, she's back to normal. It just took her a while to get initialized. I wanted to make sure she can get out of here without killing herself, because usually what happens is she runs out of here, she hits one of those rocks, and then dies. So I just make sure she's out in one piece, and now for the rest of the game, she'll just hang out at the Retching Niche. I think that's where she hangs out. I don't remember if she puts on regular clothes or if she stays in her beggar outfit. I want to say she puts on regular clothes when she gets back to Raven Rock. If I remember right, she waits for me outside. She doesn't actually just run away. Because when I go outside, she's staying right by the front door. I guess she wants to make sure that I saw her leave and that she got away safe. Half of these encounters here are scripted. No matter what you do, you're going to get detected because it's all part of script. So I don't know why I bother to sneak around here. It don't matter. This whole room here is scripted. Because you're like doing all this stuff, right? And then all of a sudden she shows up at the top of the stairs. She wasn't there before and she just spawns in the room. Because I think I used my camera to look all over the place. And she was nowhere to be found. You could see her minions are all staying around though. But once I got to a certain spot, she just appears. Let's see if I can do this right. There we go. I remember when this used to be a cool DLC, and now I don't care about this DLC anymore. I only have it because it's got Mirok. I like Mirok as a follower. And I take it back. I do like Nelloth. Nelloth is still my favorite NPC in the game. NPC, when I say NPC, I mean it in a good way. Not how it's used. Oh, I got the hiccups. I don't mean NPCs as how they're used in the real world.
You've gone far enough.
See how she just shows up?
Fool to think he could send some lowlife to finish me off.
That sucks.
That's impressive.
No, it's not impressive. It's scripted. Scripts suck.
Did you hear that noise?
Any boss fight sucks. Yeah. I just want to get through here.
You're as good as you can.
Wigmore keeps coming behind me. Why is that all about?
That's what I thought.
She kept spawning behind me and I don't know what was happening there. There's no nav mesh really in this neck of the woods, so it's kind of. It's just amazing if anyone can get through this area.
Strange.
There's somebody up there. Go kill it.
I'll kill you.
So kill it. Yeah, my music kicks in. After the thing's dead. Come on, music, you can do better than that. Anyway, so yesterday I bought some Vans. I've been wearing Vans now
this
for like 10 or 12 years, and
have to be careful so that we don't get lost.
I couldn't find the ones I was looking for in any of the stores, so I just went to Vans' website and ordered online. And it's free shipping, and they cost less on the internet from the actual Vans.com than from, you know, buying from a store, a van store. They cost 10 times, or not 10 times. They're like $10 more if I buy the same shoes at a van store. So that was weird. There had to have been a special going on. Like one of those Christmas in July sales or something. Because it just doesn't make sense that vans cost less if I buy them from the website than if I bought them from a store. And it was free shipping.
You wish to go dead. You won't get away.
I know the salespeople at Vans, they all work on commission, so they're always trying to get you to buy shoes that you don't want. Because you'll say, you know, you have a slip-on of this shoe, and they say, no, but we have something like it, but it's got a white stripe instead of a brown, you know, whatever. You're like, no, I want this shoe. You don't have it? Okay, fine. But they're going to still try to get you to buy a shoe that you don't want.
I thought I heard footsteps.
Over here.
Well, I had to do this scene twice because the first time it was just lame. The soul gems weren't shooting at me like they're supposed to. It's like, why aren't the soul gems? It was just dumb.
Talos wills it.
The whole fight scene was just lame. Because it's scripted. And one of the scripts didn't fire correctly, so the rest of the fight scene was just lame. I get here and she's already like this. It was just dumb. That was lame. I mean, I have combat sex mods installed, so they interfere as well. I don't know why they got priority over this fight scene. Because normally I can just kill an NPC.
What was I thinking?
But you're supposed to talk to her, which I forgot. I always forget. You're supposed to talk to this woman. You're not supposed to kill her. You miss out on all the fun if you just kill her.
Fascinating.
And apparently there's a mod that allows you to wear her outfit? I'm gonna have to dig that up and see if I have that installed or not. Well, it's too late now. I've already done this mod for this quest. Hey, well, let me back up there. What did I just do there? Okay, for a minute I thought there was a mod that let me rip out her heart a different way, but no, I don't have a mod. This is all vanilla stuff. See, these things are supposed to be shooting at us when we come running in here like crazy people. But I thought I'd look around anyway just to see what else maybe didn't go through the papyrus engine like it's supposed to. So I'm just going to reload. We're going to come back in here. And do it the right way. Because I want to rip out her heart. That's what I'm supposed to do. I'm supposed to rip out her heart. Keep going. Keep the pace going. Okay, when I come in here, she should start. There she is. Oh, good. Everything's working now. Yay. As I get shot in the face. Okay, you guys, come in here. What do you guys do? Okay, they're finally there catching. Okay, they're not doing anything. Oh, let me get in front of you guys. I want to do the killing.
Enjoy your last breath. Now
Now I'm gonna get you.
Okay, don't hurt her too much. I gotta talk to her first.
As good as dead.
You okay?
Oop, I didn't mean to do that. Okay, so if I talk to her, let me revive her first. Okay, now I can talk to her.
Never should have come.
Never should have come. Didn't
I tell you I was good?
Yeah. We'll talk to her. And this is why I just freaked out of her. Oh, that was lame. Oh well. Sex mods trump everything still. The animation wasn't totally coordinated. So I'm ripping a heart out of thin air. There's a mod called Ambriel, Empress or something like that. Elven Empress. And it uses that animation where you see the bad guy rips the heart out of one of the Thalmor agents. And I always wondered where that came from. Because the guy said he was using content from the game. And sure enough, he was using the animation where I'm ripping the heart out of this woman. But I had a mod making her knockout do a bleed out. She was doing bleed out instead of standing where she's supposed to be for it to look right. But oh well. Now I can go report to Nelloth that she's dead. Everyone that Nelloth knows has been killed. Don't be Nelloth's neighbor. That's all I have to say about that.